After a hiatus of 22 years, yes, you heard me correctly, 22 years it's taken since the last time a Kho Kho player won the prestigious Arjuna Award. Such is the magnitude of the achievement of Sarika Kale. Sarika Kale, of course, the former captain of the Indian women's Kho Kho team. And joining me for this discussion to talk about this momentous triumph and to talk about what this means for the future of Kho Kho is the president of the Kho Kho Federation of India, Mr. Sudhanshu Mittal, the general secretary of the Kho Kho Federation of India, Mr. M.S. Tyagi, and our very own consulting chief editor, Mr. Ayaz Memon. Gentlemen, a very good afternoon to all of you.
Same to you. Bahut shukriya hame bulane ke liye.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. It's a pleasure to have all of you. Mr. Mittal, main sabse pehle aapke saath start karunga. So I'll take us back to this one tweet of yours. Jab ye momentous occasion announced hua tha, you had tweeted saying this is the golden day for Kho Kho. After 22 years, Arjuna Award for Kho Kho player, Captain Sarika Kale awarded. Greatest boost to indigenous games as government focus on developing indigenous games. Hats off to Prime Minister and Sports Minister. Dekhiye, Mr. Mittal, I'm getting goosebumps just reading this tweet as an outsider. So I can't imagine what you must have been feeling when this award was presented to Sarika Kale. Can you walk us through the feelings of yours when this was announced?
I think it was such a great day for all of us when the announcement was made. You know, we've been struggling for this for the last 3 years. At every fora, I had been raising the issue of the indigenous games not being given due recognition. Principally because since we were not an international game in the context of world games or being a part of the Olympic movement or being a part of the Asian Games, there was a limitation for the players to be exposed to international competition and accomplishments. Kho Kho Federation, through its effort, has been able to manage organizing a lot of international events. But that still was not sufficient for the government to recognize the accomplishment of these Kho Kho players. That's the reason why I wrote. I said, I have to thank the Prime Minister and I have to thank the Sports Minister. The Prime Minister in his Man Ki Baat address had mentioned the game of Kho Kho and said these games need to be encouraged. But the push really came from Mr. Kiran Rijiju. He is such a remarkable man. A man who I think is the greatest gift to Indian sports. He knows each and every record of Asian Games, Olympics, or World Cups, or everything about sports. And his passion and his commitment to indigenous sports has no parallel. So with his kind push, with his indulgence, with his involvement, we were able to accomplish what everybody believed was an impossibility. See, in fact, it's not just 22 years, it's 35 years. On a regular basis, till 35 years back, Kho Kho used to be awarded, be a part of the national awards. But then it was suddenly stopped in 1985. After 85, it was only in 1998 that when Uma Bharti was the minister, that we got an award, Arjuna Award in Kho Kho. Subsequent to that, it was again stopped and it has restarted now. So you can understand for the entire Kho Kho fraternity, there could have been a greater moment.
Absolutely, Mr. Mittal. Mr. Tyagi, main aapke paas aunga next. Dekhi, aapko, you know, it's very good to see you. Aapse Surat mein mila tha. And us samay mujhe yaad hai, despite the rainfall, poor conditions the, zameen ekdam geeli thi, tabhi bhi hum log wo jo tournament tha, usko pull off kar paye the. I think that in many ways is the embodiment of the spirit of Kho Kho and the Kho Kho Federation of India. So Mr. Tyagi, what does this mean for Kho Kho going forward, for the future of Kho Kho, for the vision of Kho Kho?
Actually, Kho Kho, ek jitne bhi isme log jude hue hain, jo isme ek team hai, हमारे लीडर जो सुधांशु जी हैं, ये सभी डायनेमिक पर्सनालिटी के डायरेक्शन में एक इतना अच्छा डेडिकेटेडली काम करते हैं और उसमें इन्वॉल्व इस तरीके से हो जाते हैं कि विदाउट किसी पोस्ट के सोचे हो कि मेरे पास ये पोस्ट है कुछ है, तो दैट दे आर वर्क दे आर नाइट। इसी चीज को देखते हुए जो खोखो का आज गेम डे बाय डे स्टेप बाय स्टेप जो डेवलप हो रहा है, उसके लिए मैं ये कह सकता हूँ कि जो खोखो है अभी जैसे हम लोगों ने नेशनल्स के अंदर जितना भी हमारा डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैं जिसमें 524 डिस्ट्रिक्ट को हमने ऑलरेडी शुरू कर दिया है और जो बाकी 125 के करीब जो डिस्ट्रिक्ट हैं उसमें भी हम चालू करने जा रहे हैं। इसके अलावा जितना भी स्टेट को हम प्रमोशंस दे रहे हैं उसमें हमारे प्रेसिडेंट साहब ने, चेयरमैन साहब जो थे एक्स और आईओ के जनरल सेक्रेटरी हैं, उन्होंने 50,000 रुपये, 76,000 रुपये, 1,00,000 रुपये एज पर द साइज ऑफ द स्टेट के हिसाब से खोखो को डेवलप करने के लिए इंडिया में देते हैं। तो इससे क्या है, ग्रास रूट से ये गेम हमारा इंडिया के अंदर डेवलप हो रहा है, साथ साथ जो इंटरनेशनल एरिना में भी अभी हम लोगों ने ऑफिशियल्स का कोचिज का कैंप राजस्थान में लगाया, इसके बाद एक कैंप जो प्लेयर्स एंड कोचिज का दिल्ली के अंदर लगाया जिसके अंदर 65 प्लेयर्स एंड कोचिज ने पार्टिसिपेट किया। और आपको ये सुनकर ताज्जुब होगा कि कुछ लोग तो ये COVID-19 की वजह से लॉकडाउन जब हुआ उससे पहले चले गए, लेकिन 18 लोग इंडिया के अंदर 6 महीने तक रहे, जिसका रहना खाना उनका कोचिंग का जो सोशल डिस्टेंस रख करके कोचिंग का भी हमने व्यवस्था की, वो सारा सभी फेडरेशन के खर्चे पर हुआ। और उससे जो ये 16 लोग 18 लोग जो यहाँ रहे हैं उन लोगों ने खोखो को इस तरीके से अडॉप्ट कर लिया जैसे फैमिली का एक मेंबर्स अडॉप्ट कर लेता है अपने परिवार में रहने के लिए। तो इन सभी चीज़ों को देखते हुए और साथ साथ अभी जो जकार्ता में एशियाड हुए थे उसमें खोखो को एक रिकॉग्नाइजेशन का दर्जा मिला, जिसमें अब हम जो खोखो है वो एशियाड के अंदर भी रिकॉग्नाइज हो गया। तो इस तरीके से आज की तारीख ये है कि हम लोग 21 कंट्री के अंदर अच्छी तरह से खोखो का प्रचार कर चुके हैं। इसके साथ साथ हम बाकी कंट्रीज को भी इसमें इन्वॉल्व करने के लिए हम कोचिज भेजेंगे और वहाँ से टीमों का आदान प्रदान करेंगे। तो आई थिंक जो हमारा विजन है, जो हमारी सोच है, वो एशियाड वर्ल्ड कराने का है। और आई थिंक ये जैसे ही COVID-19 खत्म होता है तो हम इसको इम्प्लीमेंट कर देंगे।
त्यागी सर, आपने एक बात कही, आपने कहा कि यू नो जो खोखो फैमिली ऐसी है कि वो किसी को भी अपने परिवार के सदस्य के रूप में अडॉप्ट कर लेती है। मुझे भी एकदम ऐसी ही फीलिंग अनुभव हुई थी जब मैं सूरत आया था टू कवर खोखो फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ वन प्ले स्पोर्ट्स। एक कमेंट आया है फ्रॉम प्रदीप कपलेश ऑन अ वन प्ले स्पोर्ट्स प्लेटफॉर्म एंड ही सेज मित्तल सर जी एंड त्यागी सर जी दोनों ने खोखो की पहचान, दोनों ने खोखो को नई पहचान दी है। और अगर खोखो की पहचान के बारे में बात की, आई थिंक दैट्स अ गुड सेगवे टू Ayaz Memon. Ayaz, of course, your handle on your various Twitter account, on your various social media accounts is Cricket Wala, but I don't think that does justice to your personality. It's more like a Sports Wala, because you know you've been covering every single sport in every single nook and corner of the world, and Coco, of course, is very near and dear to you and very near and dear to 1.3 billion Indians in India. Tell me about how ye Coco ki nayi pehchan kaisi aayi hai. You know, what's been what's the evolution of Coco been like over the years since the time, you know, you started following Coco up close and personal?
So Anubhav, I mean, look, it's one of the, you know, ironies of life or Indian life is that, you know, Coco is something that all of us have played at some stage while growing up in school, you know, in our building compound with friends, etc., etc. And then it seems to me that, you know, it's also been highly neglected because after a certain age, we just kind of grow out of these sports for whatever reason. I think, you know, I mean, those, let's not get too much into that, but I think what it needed, look, I think if India needs to become a sporting nation, it must necessarily look at the indigenous sports and leapfrog from there. I mean, the basic sport for any discipline is athletics. You have to run, you have to walk well, you can, you know, you have, that leads to all the other sports. But Coco, like Kabaddi, is something that is it's in our DNA. It's running in our bloodstream. And yet we kind of grow out of it. And then once that distance becomes, you know, 8, 10, 12 years, it just falls off the radar. So as we've seen, there's a massive revival in Kabaddi. It was only a matter of time, I thought, when Kabaddi started. Because I was part of the, in a sense, when Kabaddi was coming along in 2012-13, when, you know, it got that big push. And one of the questions I kept asking the people, that those who were promoting Kabaddi, I said, what about Khokho? You know? So I think, look, there are two things that matter. And this is not to kind of, just give accolades to the administration. But unless the administration understands the sport and is willing to push it, then nobody else will support you. If the administration is willing to go that distance and say, I will push my sport, then there will be people who will willingly look at it and say, now where can we take it from point A to point B? So, ye bahut zaruri tha ke administration khud jaag jaye to the challenge. And, you know, if India today, there is livelihood in sports, there's pride in sports, there is recognition in sports, there's fame in sport. So there are lots of people willing to play all kinds of sports. It's not just, I mean, we are still a cricket-dominated country, but it's no longer a one-sport country, and I'm happy to say that. Now what we need to do is, these are sports like Kabaddi and Khokho, we need to internationalize it. We need to make a push for it to become part of a regular part of the Asiad, even the Commonwealth Games. And if not the Commonwealth Games, to hell with it, let's get into the Olympics. You know, the leap should be from Asia to the Olympics. And if we've got the muscle, we've got something like even golf has come into the Olympic fold. So why can't Kabaddi come? Kabaddi is a very interesting, very basic sport at one level. Everybody can play. It's very gender friendly. And one I must mention here, Sarika Kale getting the award is a twin victory, I think, for Khokho, as well as for, I think, for the Federation. A woman getting it will appeal a lot to that gender. And my firm belief has always been that if you keep 50% of the population out of playing sports, which is our girl child and the women, we cannot become a sporting nation. So, ye bahut badi prerna hai that you've given this award, Arjuna Award, to a lady player. You know, it'll just inspire so many girls to play to Khokho. And the minute your pyramid base becomes large, then you'll get better players at the top. And I think from there, the Federation and the Sports Ministry will take it up with the relevant international authorities and say, look, we need to have this as an international sport, as an international discipline.
Absolutely. Beautifully said, Ayaz. Mr. Mittal, you know, picking up on some of the points that Mr. Memon mentioned, Ayaz, of course, talked about how there's so many factors currently that Khokho has going in its favor. So what is your take on, you know, given the fact that we have good momentum going right now, we have positive momentum, we should definitely be capitalizing on this purple patch that we have. So how do you think we can continue this positive momentum going? How do you think we can keep the good run continuing as long as possible and further popularizing the sport of Khokho to every nook and corner of India and every nook and corner of the world, perhaps?
See, internationalizing Khokho is a very critical element. And the path for that, to me, is the success of the league, which we are planning. You know, we've called it the Ultimate Khokho League. Fortunately, we are in partnership with Mr. Amit Barman, who has so much of commitment to Khokho and so much of commitment to indigenous games that it's awe-inspiring. So, with Mr. Barman, the league we are planning, success of this league will be critical for its international acceptance. And I have no doubt that this league is going to be hugely successful. The reason for that is technology input which we are incorporating. The look and feel, you know, we let special mats, looking at the speed which is required to be maintained, as well as the safety of the players. So that, you know, we are minimizing injuries and all that. The graphics which have to go, the kind of camera angles which need to be integrated or captured, to bring out the thrill of this. This game is all about speed, agility, reflexes. This game is a phenomenal game. In fact, that is the reason why the cricketers used to play kho-kho. See, right from Tendulkar to even, they used to make the cricketers play kho-kho because it gave them all the three, agility, reflexes, and speed. Hima Das, the most accomplished, was a kho-kho player. So kho-kho has these unique requirements which develops a sports person. So what we are incorporating is the thrill of these three in the league. So the kind of slow motion technology which is going to be deployed. We have amended rules, look, as a federation, for the league or for the purpose of popularizing this game. We have amended a few rules to make it viewer friendly, keeping in view the critical. You see, it's the kho-kho was a continuous game. There was no stop. But here we have incorporated the concept of a stop because we need a replay.
Correct.
We need a replay because that replay will actually bring out the romance of kho-kho. Now, if we let the replay happen after the game is over, then the spectator interest will get lost. Secondly, you know, the criticality of a right decision by the umpire, whether somebody is out or not, has to be judged through replay. So we've incorporated this. We've incorporated the concept of a wazir. You see, kho-kho, the person who's chasing, can only go in a particular direction, cannot change the direction. But we've incorporated one person to be designated as wazir, who has the flexibility of going in any direction. So that will bring in, again, a lot of romance, a lot of, excitement, a lot of mystery in the game. Plus the graphics which have been planned, the kind of data which will get captured, the heart rate, the jumps, the length of the jump, the twist, a lot of these are being incorporated. So, all in all, the kind of experience a spectator is going to have after watching kho-kho, I think would be phenomenal. We've all talked about the success of the kabaddi. One principal reason why kabaddi succeeded was primarily because of the quality of the production of Kabaddi League.
Correct. Absolutely.
It could bring out the emotion. It could bring out the nuances of what happened. And that's a criticality. So, as I said, our endeavor is to be two steps ahead. The kind of sensors we are planning, should make it an absolutely fascinating game. Believe me, you'll get goosebumps the moment you see a player, floating in the air with the extra stretch to catch a player. We've incentivized this. We've said if you do it normally, you have 1 point. If you catch a player through a dive in the air, you get 2 points. So, there are a lot of innovations which are taking place. One more thing I want to say. See, the spectator spectrum of this game is huge. As Menon Saab had said, there is nobody who's not played kho-kho. You talk about kho-kho and there comes a smile on our face. Oh, I have also played kho-kho. Yeah. So with this kind of personal, association with the game, the acceptance or the viewership platform is huge. And it is huge for indigenous games. This government has a special focus. Talk about, you'll be surprised that the games which are being planned to be promoted, Gulli Danda. We've all played Gulli Danda. We've all played Kanchas. We've all played Lattu. We've all played Stapu. We've all played Chupan Chupai, पकड़ वो जो रुमाल को गोल सर्कल में डाल के हम लोग खेलते थे. You know, Langdi Tan, we've all played. Now, these sports have such phenomenal potential of catching the imagination of this nation. And as competitive sports, they are really, really powerful sports. I must compliment Rajiv Mehta, Rani Tiwari. We have Mrs. Rani Tiwari as Vice President of KKFI, Tyagi ji. So their effort, can you imagine that in the last meeting of the OCA, we were able to get the tag of an Asian game for Khokho. So Olympic Committee of Asia recognizes Khokho as an Asian game. Now to make it a competitive game in the next Asian Games, we have to take it as a demo game and then have it. I'm very sure that in the next Asian game, Khokho will be a competitive game. So look at the kind of advantage Khokho players will have the moment it becomes an official Asian game in the competitive section. So all these games have potential. There is patronization. And as I said, here is a political dispensation which believes in these games and which believes in assisting these games. They have come forward. They are willing to extend all. You know, can you imagine that in Jawaharlal Nehru Stadium, they have allotted space to us to have our courts there. I mean, we needed this push which is there. Rest, as I said, we partnered with Mr. Amit Barman, who's been very magnanimous in giving us a very good deal for promoting this game to the grassroots level. You know, we are looking at the National League, we are looking at state leagues, we are looking at school leagues. So we're planning competitive Khokho down to the very grassroots. It's a long struggle. One innovative initiative which is going to really take off after the COVID pandemic is contained is registration of players. We have a very ambitious target of registering crores of players who are willing to play Khokho. So the moment we get a database of these players who are anywhere in the country, in any tehsil, in any village, then we'll drop a micro plan as to how to bring them and tie them up to facilitate. See, the greatest advantage of Khokho is the lack of infrastructure which is required to play this game. There's no equipmental infrastructure which is required. So that is the reason why this can really be a game of the masses, benefiting them. It fits into the Fit India program, Khelo India program. It fits into all kind of endeavors which any sporting nation can have for its citizens. So I am looking at Khokho with a lot of future, with a lot of interest, with a lot of promise and prospects. God willing, sometime later I shall appear on your interview on your channel to talk about the laurels and the accomplishments we've been able to achieve.
Absolutely, sir. You know, we eagerly look forward to that day. Aapke muh mein ghee shakkar. You know, you touched upon a couple of things, Mr. Mittal. You spoke about innovation on the one hand, innovation especially as it pertains to production quality and broadcasting. And you also spoke about grassroots level. And I have to say, those are the two pillars of One Play Sports. We combine our innovation when it comes to a broadcasting quality in order for us to actually showcase the good work that's being done at the grassroots level. And so, Mr. Tyagi,
I would invite you to use your expertise to suggest how to improve the experiential, feel of the spectators for Khokho. Please suggest to us, be our partners in coming up with a production which is unmatched.
Absolutely, sir. We'll take it up as a challenge that we look forward to. And, broadly speaking, you know, generally speaking, let's talk a bit about the importance of the role of the media when it comes to making sure that sports such as Khokho, which I would say historically haven't quite received the same attention as maybe the crickets and the footballs of India or the crickets and the footballs of the world. Of course, the media has a very crucial role to play. So, Tyagi sir, main aapse puchunga, can you touch a bit on or elaborate on media ka kya mahatva hai in promoting the indigenous game of Khokho and promoting other such indigenous sports?
वो जी मीडिया का रोल स्पोर्ट्स के लिए नहीं बल्कि सभी चीज़ों के लिए, जो भी चीज़ें हैं चाहे वो कल्चर एक्टिविटीज़ है, स्पोर्ट्स है, एजुकेशन है, या किसी भी व्यक्ति को एक प्रमोशन लेना है, तो उसमें मीडिया एक बहुत बड़ा रोल अदा करती है। वो एक बैकबोन की तरह है, क्योंकि विदाउट मीडिया के देर आर वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू मार्केटिंग द थिंग्स। अभी आप कबड्डी का देख लीजिएगा, कबड्डी जो है थोड़े दिन पहले जब तक लीग शुरू नहीं हुआ तब तक उसको कोई नहीं जानता था। मैं भी कबड्डी से जुड़ा हुआ था, कबड्डी कहते हुए भी व्यक्ति को थोड़ा ऐसे लगता था कि दे आर बिलोंग टू सम रूरल एरिया और उसका कोई अस्तित्व नहीं है, कोई उस गेम का महत्व नहीं है। लेकिन जैसे ही स्टार ने लीग शुरू किया, आज हम ये कह सकते हैं कि कबड्डी जो है वो क्रिकेट के मुकाबले बराबर की हैसियत से खड़ा हुआ है। तो जब कबड्डी जैसा गेम जो एक प्योरली इंडिजीनियस और देहात का खेल है, उसको प्रमोशन करने में मीडिया का इतना बड़ा हाथ है, तो खोखो में तो वो सारी क्वालिटीज हैं जो एक खिलाड़ी के लिए चाहिए, जो एक फिट व्यक्ति के लिए चाहिए। जैसा सुधांशु सर ने बताया, इसके अंदर वो सारी मोटर क्वालिटीज़ हैं, चाहे वो फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी है, एजिलिटी है, नैरो मस्कुलर कोऑर्डिनेशन है, स्ट्रेंथ है, एजिलिटी है, ये सारी ही मोटर क्वालिटीज़ जिस गेम के अंदर है, उस खेल के अंदर देखने में भी जैसे सर ने बताया कि जैसे डाइविंग है, दूसरा स्किल है, उन सभी को देख करके जो दर्शक हैं एक बार अगर इसे देख लेते हैं तो पूरा मोहित हो जाते हैं। तो जब ये सारी स्किल, ये सारी चीज़ें मीडिया दिखाएगा, तो देखने वाले यंगस्टर्स और जो उनके पेरेंट्स हैं उसको लाइक करेंगे, और लाइक नहीं करेंगे बल्कि उसे एडॉप्ट कर लेंगे। आप जैसे सूरत में गए थे तो मुझे याद है कि शायद आपको भी खोखो में काफ़ी इंटरेस्ट जब से डेवलप हुआ होगा। तो जब किसी भी चीज़ को पसंद करने के लिए उसका खेलना, देखना, सीखना और उसको दिखाना, ये सारी चीज़ें जब तक व्यक्ति के जहन में नहीं आएगी, जब तक उसे अपना नेकेड आई से नहीं देखेगा, तब तक उसमें इन्वॉल्व होना बड़ा मुश्किल है। और ये काम केवल मीडिया का हो सकता है। तो दैट मीडिया इज ए रियली बैकबोन ऑफ दिस एनी स्पोर्ट्स और एक्टिविटीज। तो मीडिया का तो बहुत बड़ा रोल है सर।
Absolutely, Mr. Tyagi. And Ayaz, the one thing that I'll ask you is, and I'm pretty sure, you know, ever since this was announced, Sarika Kale's historic triumph, there'll be lots of other Khokho players in India who must have been really galvanized and inspired by this news, right? Of course, recognition matters, as they say. So how do you think, psychologically speaking, how do you think this news of Sarika Kale's award has affected up-and-coming Khokho players, people who aspire to be Khokho players? How do you think they've been galvanized?
Well, I think, look, it's an eye-opener. So one thing is that you will get recognition even if you are in a sport like Khokho, which otherwise people used to feel. So one of the challenges Mr. Mittal faces, and I think he's more aware of it than I am, is that now Khokho has to be made mainstream sport. Earlier, the perception was this is a Mufassil sport or a rural sport. Now it needs to be made mainstream. Like Kabaddi has been mainstream. Tyagi sahab ne bhi yehi bataya, Mittal sahab ne bhi yehi bataya. There needs to be a lot of hard work done at the back end, which I'm sure they've been doing most assiduously. Now there has to be kind of a big bang frontal approach coming up with the league, driven by, you know, reshaping some rules to make it more attractive for the consumer, for the sports lovers, using cutting edge technology to drive home the message of the excitement of the sport. These are challenges that every federation faces, and that requires imagination, stamina and commitment. All three are important from the federation's point of view, because there may be lots of players who are doing a lot of good work, but unless that basic push is coming from within the federation, it may not reach the masses, which is where it should reach. So I think Sarika Kale winning this award is a great achievement for her, but not just for her, for the sport. And also, so if I was, I'm just putting on my, you know, I'm using my imagination. If I was a 12, 13-year-old boy or girl who's played some Khokho in school And I'm thinking now, what else can I do? You know, मेरा कौन से स्पोर्ट में मुझे रिकॉग्निशन मिलेगी? I may be talented, gifted. At the age of 12, 13, a lot of kids play 3, 4, 5 sports. Then they pick and choose a sport and pursue that. And I would have, in the normal course of things, not given Khokho too much attention because I didn't see a roadmap or a path to take me anywhere. Now, I'm seeing a path. There is a player who gets the Arjuna Award. It's not just, you know, it's a great accolade, but it's also a great inspiration. And then if it is followed up with, you know, more activities, more tournaments, more recognition at the national, Asian, international level, a league coming in which promises not just, you know, attention from the masses, but also perhaps scope of a livelihood, then as a 12, 13-year-old, I will make my commitment to Khokho. So that's the big deal that happens. Otherwise, I would say, okay, you know, I'm a good athlete. You know, I've got the ability to, I've got reflexes, I've got speed, I've got agility, but they may be of use in other sports also. But now I will choose Khokho because I see, you know, rainbow at the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow, so to speak.
Absolutely. Is Mr. Mittal still on?
Last minute. Hello.
Oh, Mr. Mittal might be slightly tied up. Mr. Tyagi, main aapke paas aunga. Tyagi sir, mujhe ek cheez bolna padega ki, you know, I've had lots of conversations with lots of Khokho players. Jab main Surat mein tha, but even after that, Sarika se baat hui thi last week. Sarika ke coach Mr. Chandrajit Jadhav, unse bhi baat hui thi. Sab log kehte hai ki Mr. Tyagi has been like a father figure for all the Khokho players. Matlab jab bhi unko kuch bhi sankat aaye, koi bhi problem hoti hai, they can always come to Mr. Tyagi and wo ek solution unko de denge. Suppose unko achha nahi lag raha hai, koi financial problem hai, koi bhi problem hai, then you come to the rescue. Ye jo aapka vishesh sambandh hai Tyagi sir Khokho players ke saath, you know, despite the post that you have, despite the fact that aap kafi vyast hai with lots of other things, ye aap itna intimate relationship, intimate sambandh kaise rakhte hai? Can you touch upon this special relationship that you have with the Khokho players?
सर ये अभिनव जी, ये तो अगर मेरे से ज़्यादा सुधांशु जी के लिए कहें तो बहुत अच्छा लगेगा, बिकॉज सुधांशु जी जो है वो बहुत ही मिलनसार और हेल्पफुल आदमी है. लेकिन मेरा जहाँ तक खोखो से संबंध है, मैं खिलाड़ी रहा हूँ, उसके बाद मैं कोच रहा हूँ, फिर एडमिनिस्ट्रेटर रहा, अभी मैं फेडरेशन में जनरल सेक्रेटरी. तो सर मुझे मालूम है कि एक परिवार के अंदर यदि आप उसे जोड़ के रखना चाहते हो तो उसके दर्द, उसकी वेलफेयर और उसके सुख दुख के साथ साथ उसको किस तरीके से आगे बढ़ना है, किस तरीके से उसको मोटिवेट करना है, ये सारा तभी आदमी बता पाएगा, तब उसका खुद का अनुभव होगा. मुझे मालूम है जब हम खिलाड़ी थे तो हम लोग ट्रेन से आते थे, कई बार रिजर्वेशन नहीं होता तो बाथरूम के सामने जो खाली जगह होती है उसमें बैठ कर आते थे. आज हम लोग प्लेन में आ रहे हैं तो यही चीज मैंने अनुभव किया और मैंने सुधांशु सर की काइंडनेस और जो अपने राजीव मेहता जी हैं उनसे चर्चा की. तो आज हम खिलाड़ियों को अगर ट्रेन से भी बुलाते हैं तो एसी से बुलाते हैं, फ्लाइट से बुलाते हैं, उनके पूरा वेलफेयर का ध्यान रखते हैं. और सबसे बड़ी चीज यह है कि हम अपने आप को जनरल सेक्रेटरी नहीं मानते, बल्कि मैं अपने आप को उनका एक फैमिली मेंबर मानता हूँ, एक बड़ा परिवार का सदस्य मानता हूँ. और उनका सुख दुख जिस तरीके से भी हम उसे दूर कर सकते हैं, मैं कर सकता हूँ तो मैं करूँगा, नहीं तो मैं उसका रिक्वेस्ट अपने प्रधान साहब को, सुधांशु जी को करता हूँ. तो आई थिंक इसी चीज़ को देखते हुए सभी लोग, हो सकता है मुझे अपने बड़े भाई की तरह, पेरेंट्स की तरह प्यार करते हो, सच मैं भी उनको बिल्कुल अपने परिवार की तरह ही देखता हूँ और मैं चाहता हूँ कि वो इसी तरह से मेरे से प्यार करते रहे, मैं भी उसको करता रहूँ. तो एक हमें शक्ति मिलेगी, ताकत मिलेगी इस गेम को ऊपर ले जाने की.
Absolutely. Mr. Mittal actually had to leave because something did come up urgently, but I'm pretty sure he will watch everything that you had to say, Mr. Tyagi. Mr. Tyagi, my final question for you. देखिए, हम लोग खोखो के बारे में बात किए हैं एट अ ब्रॉडर लेवल, एट अ हाई लेवल. सारिका के बारे में थोड़ी बात करते हैं. ऑफ कोर्स यू हैव स्पेंड टाइम विथ हर, यू वॉच्ड हर, यू ऑब्जर्व्ड हर एट क्लोज क्वार्टर्स. तो सारिका में क्या खास बात है, व्हाट इज सो स्पेशल इन हर कि उसको ये अवार्ड मिला आफ्टर 22 इयर्स, उसको ये रिकॉग्निशन मिली? व्हाट आर सम ऑफ द ट्रेट्स एंड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट शी हैज दैट मेक्स हर सच अ स्पेशल टैलेंट? एंड आई एम प्रीटी श्योर जो भी अभी देख रहे हैं खो खो के प्लेयर्स ऑन वन प्ले स्पोर्ट्स के पेज पे, खो खो फेडरेशन ऑफ इंडिया के पेज में, द पीपल हु हैव हाई एम्बिशंस विल डेफिनेटली बेनिफिट अ लॉट फ्रॉम दिस आंसर. तो सारिका में क्या खास बात थी?
सर ऐसे होता है कि जब कोई भी किसी स्पोर्ट्स का या एजुकेशन का या किसी भी चीज का हाईएस्ट अवार्ड उस व्यक्ति को मिलता है जिस व्यक्ति के अंदर डेडिकेशन होगा उस चीज के लिए, उसका मेहनत होगा, उसका सोच होगा आगे बढ़ने का. ये बच्चा मैंने देखा है शुरू से ही कि ये एक सिंपल और कूल एंड कम, बिल्कुल एक जैसे कहते हैं ना अपने काम से काम इसका रहता था, खेल से ही मतलब होता था. ये मैंने बहुत कम, अब जो अवार्ड मिला उसके बाद मैंने इसे ज्यादा बोलते देखा है, अदरवाइज ये नमस्ते करके अपना लगी रहती थी. लेकिन इसका जो डेडिकेशन है, जो इसका गेम के प्रति इसका प्यार है, मेरा मानना है कि यदि किसी चीज को प्राप्त करना है कोई भी चीज हो तो उसके साथ आसकी करनी पड़ती है, उसके साथ एकदम पागलपंथी हो जाना, पागल बन जाना पड़ता है, तब जाकर कोई अचीव होता है. तो मुझे इसमें कहते हुए जरा भी हेजिटेशन नहीं होगा कि सारिका को इस गेम के प्रति, इस खोखो परिवार के प्रति पागलपन था, एक अटैचमेंट था, एक लगन थी. उस चीज को उसका आज हम कह सकते हैं कि उसने ये जो इतना बड़ा हम लोगों का मान बढ़ाया है, हम लोगों को एक कह सकते हैं हम प्राउड फील हो रहा है कि उसे ये अवार्ड मिला है, गवर्नमेंट ने उसे अवार्ड दिया है, वो इसके काबिल थी. और मैं यूथ से सभी से यही कहूँगा, जिस तरीके से उसको अटैचमेंट था कोको से, जिस तरीके से उसने इसके लिए मेहनत किया, उसका लगन थी, उसका जिसे हम कह सकते हैं प्यार था, अगर आप लोगों में भी होगा तो आप लोगों को भी वो दिन दूर नहीं होगा जब आप इस स्तर तक पहुंचने में आपको कोई रोक सकेगा.
यू नो, टू सम अप व्हाट मिस्टर त्यागी जस्ट सेड, यू नीड अ स्पेशल काइंड ऑफ ऑब्सेशन विद द स्पोर्ट इन ऑर्डर टू स्केल द ग्रेटेस्ट ऑफ हाइट्स, एंड दैट्स एग्जैक्टली व्हाट सारिका काले हैज डन. बट I am sure that none of her achievements would have been possible without all the love, care, attention and support that she received from the Kho Kho Federation of India, from Mr. M.S. Tyagi, from Mr. Sudhanshu Mittal, as well as all the other administrators who have been a part of her success. But this is just the beginning of a new chapter, and I'm pretty sure everything that's taken place over the past week, a couple of weeks, bodes well for the future of Kho Kho. As I said, this is just the start, and One Play Sports certainly hopes to be at the forefront of this beautiful journey that will take place on the Kho Kho front. Mr. Tyagi, thank you so much for all your efforts, for all your attention, for all your contributions to the sport of Kho Kho, to sport in general in India. Ayaz, thanks as always for joining us and sharing your lovely views. And Mr. Mittal, if you're watching, thank you so much for being a part of this special episode on One Play Sports. And we look forward to having many such discussions in the future as well, because I am sure that Kho Kho will go on to break many, many, many more records and achieve many, many more milestones in the future. And a big thank you to all the viewers on One Play Sports, as well as on the various Kho Kho Federation of India pages, for having tuned in for this live chat. Thank you so much for all your comments, for your love and support. Do definitely share this live stream amongst your friends and family members, and stay tuned on our One Play Sports networks for gripping sports action for you guys in the future as well. Thank you so much, everyone.
थैंक यू अरुणा जी,
थैंक यू
मैन साहब, और मैन साहब आप जुड़े रहेंगे तो